Hi everyone, this video will see how to use the mail merge option to create multiple letters for communication in an office environment. Okay, actually what is the process here is we have to mail merge option to create multiple letters in an office environment. Actually, what is the concept of mail merges? We have a series of recipients in an office, and we want to send the message to all the recipients. Okay, so for that, what we have to do? We have to create the body of the letter, that is the content which has to be conveyed, and then we have to connect those mail to the multiple recipients. We will see this particular mail merge option in this MS Word using this following steps. Okay, so now for that, what we have to do is we have to first open the MS Word. Once you open the MS Word option, you have to click to the file. We are having a new option is here, then you select new and then blank document. So once you open empty blank document is opened, and then you have to go to the option called mailings. Okay, in the mailings you have the start mail merge option is there. Okay, so now you have to click on the start mail merge option. In the last we have the step by step mail merge wizard. This mail merge wizard will help you to go through the steps of the mail merge. Okay, so now click on this particular mail merge wizard, and then you can to the right corner you can see the options. Step one is you have to select the document you are going to send. So now here chooses by default letters is chosen. We can also choose either email messages, envelopes, labels or directory, but normally we send letters, so the default is letter is chosen. That is the first option, and then we have to go for the starting document. Okay, so now next we are going to select the recipients. Actually, what is the concept is I have a particular data to be sent, and that data has to be passed to many people. Okay, suppose I just type the message, hello everyone, and then I am going to send this message to every people. Okay, and then I am wishing them like all the best to everyone. Okay, so this is the message I have to going to send to the different people, different recipients. So now the letter is ready. This is the body of the letter, and then the letter is ready now. Okay, now I have to mention to whom all I have to send this particular message. So I have to give the, that is the next step, which is the select recipients. So what is the select recipients is, once you click on this select recipients, you will get some options where we have use an existing list or select from the Outlook context or a type a new list. Using the existing list means a particular record of the employee may be inside the database. We must have created earlier and it may be available in the existing record. We can use those data for sending the recipients, sending the mail to the recipients. Otherwise, we can type a new list. In my case, I didn't have any mail list, so I am just giving a type new list. Once I give the type new list option, you can see the create option. This create will create a set of recipients. Okay, so now I have to give some, these are all the fields. Title is one field where the first name is given some value, and then the last name is again giving some value, and then the company I am giving some value, and then the address line is 1234. When I want to add more data, I just click new entry, and then you can also add new data, and then you can go through using this tab. You can type the recipients addresses, first name, last name and so on. Okay, and then this is how the addresses has to be filled. So I am a new entry, and then giving a new entry, and then I am typing some data over here, and then this is the first name, this is the last name, and then this is the company name and some address name. There are so many fields are there. If you want, you can use it. Okay, And then if I don't want this entry, I can use the delete entry. If I give delete entry, the particular entry will be deleted. It is just giving an option yes or no. If I give yes, it will delete it. Now I wanted it, so I'm giving no. Okay, so now I am adding one more entry, the fourth entry, which is having some data over here. Like this, I can keep on adding as many data as I wish. Okay, so now this is the this way that the create recipients has to be done. Okay, so now this is the fifth one, and then I am giving some value, and this is the data, and this is the last data, and this is the company address. Okay, so now the thing is over. Now I can just click OK, and now I want to save this. Okay, if I give OK, it is giving an option to save the file, and I am giving this database as sample. Okay, sample, and it is stored in .mdb extension, and then click save. Okay, so now this step is over. It is showing all the recipients list. Okay, so then what I have to do is then now click OK, and let it be there. Okay, so now the list is ready, the recipients is ready. Now I have to go to the next step. Okay, so write your letter. So here in this, I can, in writing this letter, what I can do is I can add the address block. Okay, so address block is like this is the, you can see the first address I have typed in the previous screen. This is the second address, third address, fourth address, and fifth address. I have five addresses over here. Okay, so now I can use this address elements over here. So I am giving a click OK. So the address block is ready. You can see on the screen the address block is ready. Okay, and I can place this address block wherever I want. I can just select this as normal, and then I can just control X, and I can place wherever I want. I can just place the address block. Wherever I place this address block, the address will be inserted after running the mail merge option. And then I have a greeting line. What is this greeting line is? Here it is a greeting line. So it is giving some hi, dear, hello, and so on. Okay, so I just giving a greeting line here, giving us dear. Okay, so okay, so enter. So now the greeting line is here, and then the content is here, then address block is here, and then again the contents are here. Okay, I can also add more and more items over here, but this is the minimum thing we require: the address block, greeting line, and the document. So now next I have to go to the preview your letter. What is the preview your letter is? Once I click on this, I will get a sample of the particular letter. You can see here, dear, one recipient name, hello everyone, this is the address block, and then all the best. Okay, now I have to complete the merge. What this step will do is, here it is only one document is given, it is the first record. Okay, and once I click this complete the merge, you can see all the five letters, because I have five addresses, five letters will be created. So I can see edit individual letters. It is asking the option all current record or from to this. What does it mean is, I can use all the records to send. For example, a student list may be 100 in numbers, a staff may be having the full list. He or she want to send only the list to 10 members or 20 members. Okay, so there they can say from 10, okay, and then to 20. If they press 10 to 20, only those members will be getting the mail. If I say the current record means, what is the current record is pointed, that will be given the mail. If I give all the records will be used. Now in our case we have five records, so I wanted to send the data to all the five recipients. So I am giving click all and then give OK. So once I click OK, you can see five letters. You can see here in this option, six pages are here showing that page one having the first address, and then you go through this. Now this is page 2, so dear 2 and some address, this is the address block, and then dear 3, some address block, this message and all the best, and then dear 4 and some values, address and this all the best, and then finally dear 5, fifth member, and this communication and this all the best. So this is how the mail merge works. Even though there are hundreds of recipients, just this procedure steps from 1 to 6 will help you to create a mail merge list, which is a very important advantage, important option, important application used in an office environment. Hope you all have understood this clearly. Thanks for watching.